That's Hiromi Uyura, Note from the Past. Okay. Cambridge Audios. Now, they've been here for a while. I apologize to the owner for... because they're borrowed. Most things are borrowed. Except for that, all of you, I own you. And I haven't done Cambridge before. Come. Take the cover off. Oh, it's adorable. And it is adorable. Look at it. Let's pull it off. It's high horse. These are the SX50s, right? I'll take a peek at it before I put it back up on the stand. It's you know what it is? It's the right size for a bookshelf. I've got a couple other bookshelves coming up. I got a couple that are just like, what the... You know, bookshelves don't get that big. They're like perfect for if you want to build a vat, because they're tall. But I mean, this is what I think of when I think of bookshelves. It's this size. I don't have the exact dimension, but I'm pretty sure you can't tell which way is facing up, because it's a perfect square. Rear's got this nice flared port, which is in a matte black, and I could see inside. I see your secrets. Standard binding posts. 8 ohms, rated 10 to 100 watts, 87 decibels efficiency. For those of you who don't know, if you put a watt into a speaker, there's a certain amount of sound pressure that will come out of it. And that's the sensitivity. And the sensitivity is 87. Now, the thing about smaller speakers is they're usually a lot less sensitive. Like the clips up there, the RP150Ms, are like 94. So you put a watt into those, they get 94 decibels. You put a watt into these, they get 87 decibels. It's less. And that means you need a little more power, a little more to get it going. That's why I like the little Mica Kovo S is a little tiny ones that are like, you know, that big. You needed like a God amp to push them to any sort of volume. And then they'd blow up at the same time. So, I mean, look at this. This is just, you could just smell the old world British design sort of lingo going on. I come from Cambridge. Yes. The grills use pegs, and I'm going to have to bring that up because a lot of the new ones I have use pegs instead of magnets, and I don't know what the hell the problem is. Magnets, everyone should get magnets going on. But again, old school. Nice, big soft dome. This is like 5 1/4. Unless it's a 5, it might be a 5. A lot of those weird ones have a 5. 5 1/4. Okay, good. By the way, $250 a pair, so not cheap. You're not competing these versus Mica MB42Xs. First of all, these would win for sound. And they're 2.5-3 times the price? That would be 270. Yeah, they're expensive. But in that ballpark, there's a couple competitors that we have to discuss. Like, if you wanted to go powered. So if you're not going powered, if you're going passive, this is passive. It needs an amplifier. It doesn't need that amplifier, but we'll talk about that in a second. But if you want to like the JBL Studio, I've lost my mind. LSR-305s, the studio threw me off. The LSR-305s there, you can get for around 200. 200 if they're on crazy sale, 250 if they're not on sale, so about the same price. So, let me tell you what these do that will make you buy them over the 305s. I had them set up in the living room in my home theater. No, they're not giant home theater speakers, but 5 1/4 is becoming like a standard size, so they should be able to do something out there. And if you use a receiver to cut off the low end, then you could just pass that along to a subwoofer and everything should be hunky-dory. And these would not get loud enough out there. Here on the desk, in the desk triangle, which is supposed to always, by the way, set up in a equilateral triangle, if that and that speaker are 4.5 feet apart, you should be 4.5 feet from that speaker and that speaker, and that'll be perfect. Which I could sort of simulate here. On a real desk, if you're a real human being, a real boy or girl, we have to assume there's a girl out there watching this. If you're a girl, comment please and then date me. They work here on a desk a little better than they do out there in the room. See, because I had them on the room on these stands because I've got the Walshes in there, so I don't have my Doom Stack set up. And I brought them in a little bit. You know, TV was there. I moved my couch forward, brought them in, and I'm like, let's try these. I've tried a whole bunch of other speakers, and I'm just, all right. And I put these on, and it's like, Jesus Christ, these are sweet. And that's the only word that keeps coming up in my mind when it's like, well, how did those Cambridge Audio SX50 sound, Zeus? And it's going to be sweet. And I know I'm going to have a little stroke now trying to explain how, you know, a taste can be translated to a speaker. Can I put these back now? I really want to hear them again. You know, standard fare of binding posts.
You go there, girl. You go, girl.
In fact, let's take let's strip them naked because they don't look bad. Not even a little. If they didn't have this touch around the outside, the black around hiding the screws, I would not yet know what decade these are from. They could be from the 80s, or they could be from the early 90s, or they could be from 2017, which is when they're from. Sweet, back to sweet. Certain genres, certain songs, there's dust on there. Certain genres and certain songs on these speakers just sound perfect. LSR-305s, they sound great as everything. They are monitors, they're designed to be neutral and flat. And these are soft. Just straight up, you know, not dull. I mean, I remember when I did the Pioneer BS-21s, the original Pioneers. I said, those are dull. Like, you couldn't do anything with them. Nothing high came out of it. These are soft. It's going to be very quiet. It's a very professional, very, very soothing sound. If you want if you're a person that listens to, like Nine Inch Nails came on before, and I was trying to listen to Nine Inch Nails, and these, and I was sort of like, they're not, I need them to, Nine Inch Nails need to have attack you. Heavy metal, you need to have a little bit more in the violent, ear-bleeding department. And these couldn't do it. Good. I'm bored. If speakers are all the same and they all do everything, so that's fine. I'd rather find a speaker like these that has a very specific purpose. And the purpose of these speakers is to lull you to sleep. Oh my God. I guess in the big room, in the big living room, out there, I was not wowed by many of the recent speakers. I'm like, I put them on, ooh, these sound really good. But these speakers sounded different. Different's good. Different means I have something to talk about now. When all the speakers sound the same, it's sort of like, we're going to talk right now about these. Code Geass. I can't do it. Great, great anime, and I hope they don't fuck it up with the second season. It doesn't need to be a second season. Calm. I'm forming words. Give me a second. These are therapeutic speakers. That's what these are. And I would say, oh, if you have a vinyl setup, get these. But vinyl's already a softer format, because it uses analog and the needle could be a little bit worn. You know, sometimes there's a harshness to it. So automatically that's stripped off of Moog music when you get to vinyl, and that's why people like it. And these speakers bring that sort of tranquility to everything you play on them. Now, if you know a genre that you like and it's very aggressive and hardcore, these probably won't work for you. But if you're a not aggressive, hardcore person, if this is what you play, and that, by the way, is Ludovico Einaudi. It's some other language. I don't know. That. Can you read that? Because I can't say it. I hope that more speakers like this come about, because they're just very specific. Like those boot carts over there. What was the big boot carts, the big daddy boot carts that are, you know, $1,200-$1,300 a pair, probably still the best passive speakers I've ever heard. Just in a room, not so much on a desk. Those were the same exact thing, just a little bit smaller, so they worked on a desk. But being great is you know, that's okay, check it out. What are you great? What are you good at? Everything. Boring. I like to find things that are very specific. These are the best at this. If you own a spa, and I know, I don't know how many of you people, I mean, I have 50,000 subscribers, and maybe I'll get 12 to 15,000 views ever. So that's how many people are actually watching. And I'm sure one of you owns a spa. There's good odds. Buy these speakers for your spa. They are calming. If your person likes to study with music on, get these instead of the 305s. They don't need much power, and one of the reasons that I set the Phase Linear 400 up here is because they have those beautiful Cylon-inspired VU meters that show me exactly how many watts are being used. And I have the DBX GORAC here because that's a power amp. It has no, those volumes, they're not volume controls, and there's not even a power switch on it. So I could push these to their limits, and their limit is not very high. Let's get it. See? That's Bloodborne. It's not Lord of the Rings. So good. Jeremy Soule. Rage Against the Machine. Like right here, guitars. Beautiful world. I can live with this. When you get to real thrashy stuff, then it's going to sort of fall apart. But for just, the bass is lessened. There's not a lot of low end coming out of these. They actually do have these massive port stuffs as well, which are deeper than I would expect for most things. And you could put them in if you get these right against a wall, and it might help any like boominess from happening. But I would try them without it first. Let the boominess happen. Just let it happen. And then listen to them. And then listen to them again. Door. Lyra Lynn, I'm Your Fool. The imaging. Let's talk about imaging for a second. As good as the 305s. Just as good. Even that crazy, crazy waveguide. He's not having nearly any waveguide, just that little bit of recess. Dead center, vocal imaging, and I hear things moving across. And it's like a wash with just softness. I'm trying to think what other speaker reviewers would say in this situation. They'd be like, well, the phase disturbance of the real close. Who cares? I'm telling you exactly what you need to do to know to buy these speakers. If you're this person, if you're the kind of person who wants to listen to the music with just the edge taken off, just your two shots of just the oldest scotch in, and now it's time to listen to music. These are two shots of scotch. Should we go with that system now for reviewing speakers? Let me think, what are the most harsh? Actually, those Emotivas now, the original ones that I, my first good pair of speakers, those are like two shots of goddamn wild turkey. And take your clothes off. These, there's got to be a fire burning. You've got to be just a little buzzed. Just a little buzzed. And then just music. That's what these are. And they're not cheap, but I mean, they look damn good. They look damn good. And they sound just, for how I know they're supposed to sound, they sound flawless. They don't sound great for everything. You push a lot of violent music through it, and let's see if I could jump to something.
I've been rapping for a block, so.
Even that's Rat-Tat-Tat 17 years. I'm going to keep saying the songs because I keep getting comments like, what was that song? And then if people don't put a timestamp, then I can't find it because I'm not watching the entire thing and listening every song. So I'll just say, that's Rat-Tat-Tat 17 years. It's just softening it up. I know how that song, how this whole artist sounds. And it's not super shrill, but there's a bit of an edge to it. And it just goes away, and I could still listen to it. I'm trying to middle ground these speakers where it's like, I'm telling you why I like them, I'm telling you how I like them, I'm telling you what genre I like listening to. But you can still get away with, like, the Redline OST, Ren and Stimpy. I mean, I have a lot. Let's face it, I'm a soft music kind of guy, except for Geschaffelstein. There you go. You could hear the bass kick. It doesn't have the volume of air. It doesn't have a big enough box to make the bass kick happen. So it's a little subdued, and I can almost fix that with subsynth. I think I have it on 50% here. 55%. I could bring up that that it's missing. It's just a little bit of that. These with a subwoofer, a very, very small, well, again, subwoofer size is room dependent. So a subwoofer designed for the room, set as low as possible to help these out. Fall asleep to them. In a good way, not like in a boring, they're boring way, in a soft, gentle, massaging way. All right, I'm happy with this review. I was worried because I was like, how am I going to describe these? Because they don't work for everything, but they work so well for certain things. And here you go. Power requirements, I never exceeded 10 watts per channel. Even though they're low efficiency, watching the cool VU meters, 10 watts per channel was getting to like the edge of where I'd think these are happy. So that means they're real close to 20, so that means you probably want at least a 25 watt per channel to a 50 watt per channel amp, SA50, something like that. A2. I mean, that thing is 200 watts per channel. I just have it limited with the things, limited here, and I don't even think I got the input of the Emotiva down, or the output of it just down, and now they play. So you don't have to like budget $700 for an amplifier. God, they're so sweet. Sweet. Sweet, like an ice cream truck man. But not the kind that drags you into the back and rapes you. Not that one. The real kind. The happy, normal kind. There's only two left on Amazon. And there are bigger models, and I can't wait to maybe throw some Patreon money at it. I'm not 100. They're so nice. They're the Aero 2s are... Are those each? It says bookshelves. $250 for a pair, and they're bigger. These also come, by the way, in black. Or this, what, walnut. Walnut or black. Or white. No, that's Mini XLs. Different model. And they're more money. All right. If you're the kind of guy that's, or the girl,